Hello, I'm Brian Gaines, a developer in the Advanced Analytics Division and R&D at SAS. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use the task in SAS Studio to easily perform a competing risk survival analysis. Survival analysis focuses on the time until the occurrence of an event of interest. The name is derived from its widespread use in medical applications, where historically death was a common event of interest. However, it has wide-ranging applications, such as the time until an item stops working, or the time until a customer buys a product or service. Because of the special nature of these data, specialized methods such as Kaplan-Meier estimates and the Cox regression model have been developed. These traditional survival methods are widely used when they assume only one outcome of interest. However, often in reality, a subject can experience other relevant events that prevent the event of interest from occurring. These events are called competing risk because the occurrence of one event precludes the occurrence of the other events. For example, a patient could die before experiencing relapse, or a customer could buy a product or service from a competitor. For data of this type, specialized methods should be used because traditional survival analysis techniques are not appropriate. There are two main techniques for modeling competing risk data. The first method models the cost-specific hazard function, which is a generalization of the standard hazard function. This approach can be accomplished by simply fitting a traditional Cox proportional hazards model for the event of interest and treating all competing risk as right-censored. Alternatively, the method of fine and gray focuses on the cumulative incidence function, which is the probability of failure due to a specific cause. Instead of censoring the competing risk, this approach modifies the risk set to take the competing risk into account. These two approaches should be viewed as being complementary, and their use depends on your goals of the analysis. If your goal is inference, then researchers have suggested using the cost-specific approach because it is more interpretable, whereas the fine and gray model is recommended when prediction is the goal because it directly models the CIF. Suppose you are interested in the disease-free survival associated with a certain disease and treatment. Here, death is a competing risk because it impedes the occurrence of a relapse. As an example, let's analyze a data set that contains information about leukemia patients who underwent a bone marrow transplant, which is a standard treatment for acute leukemia. We have data for 137 patients who are grouped into three different categories according to their disease status at the time of the transplant. We also have a time covariate that represents the time a patient had to wait before receiving the transplant. The goal in this analysis is to compare and predict the disease-free survival for the different groups after controlling for a patient's waiting time. As I mentioned, I'm going to use the task in SAS Studio to perform these analyses. If you are unfamiliar with SAS Studio, I encourage you to visit the SAS Studio product page to learn more about its array of productivity-boosting features. If you do not have access to SAS Studio, it is available with SAS University Edition, which is free for non-commercial use and is what I am using for this demo. After opening SAS Studio, to access the task, you click on the Task and Utilities section on the left and then expand the Task folder to display the tasks that we have developed at SAS. As you can see, we've developed tasks that cover a wide range of analytical areas. For this example, we are interested in the survival analysis category, so let's expand that and then double-click to open the proportional hazards regression task. When you open a task, on the left you have the settings and options for the task, and on the right you have the work area. The code editor initially consists of comments in the code that list the items that must be addressed before you can run the task. The first thing you need to specify is your data set, so let's select the BMT-CR data set that was created earlier. For survival time, let's select the T variable, which contains the disease-free survival time. Next, let's select status as the status variable, and then specify 0 for the censoring value, since 0 indicates which observations were right-censored. Let's then select competing risk analysis to display the additional options that are available. The event of interest is the value of your status variable that corresponds to relapse, which in this case is 1, so let's select that. Let's keep the modeling approach as fine and gray for now. Now you need to specify the explanatory variables to include in the model. First, for the categorical variables role, let's select the group variable. After making that selection, you can see that the code has been automatically generated in the code window since the task requirements are now met. You can see the model statement with T as the survival time variable in addition to group as a covariate. Generally, the tasks are designed so that you need to make only a few selections to be able to run the task, But the tasks also provide you with a lot more options to customize the analysis, as you will see. First, let's change the effect parameterization to reference coding to match the procedure's default. Next, let's select the log wait time variable as a continuous variable since you want to include that in your model. Notice that after you make these changes, the code in the code window automatically updates in real time. You can see that the log wait time variable also appears in the model statement now. This automatic code generation can be a useful tool for learning SAS syntax. Now that you have selected your variables, you can use the Options tab to explore the additional options available in the task. For example, you can request plots of the estimated cumulative incidence functions at different values of the explanatory variables, which is often of interest in a competing risk analysis. To do this, you must first create a data set that contains the covariate values that you are interested in which each line in the data set corresponds to a different set of values. For example, let's run this SAS code to create a small data set that you can use to estimate the CIF for each disease group using a value of 5.2 for log wait time, which corresponds to about 6 months. Let's return to the task and select the risk data set for this purpose. And let's also select group for the curve ID variable. Now click the running person icon to run the task and obtain the results. From the results, you can see that there is a significant group effect on relapse, but that is not the case for the transplant waiting time. In addition, if you scroll down, the graph of the estimated cumulative incidence function shows that a patient in the high-risk group is more likely to relapse than patients in the other groups, while those in the low-risk group are less likely to relapse. Those are the results using the Find and Gray model, but the task also enables you to easily estimate the cost-specific hazard model. To see this, let's return to the Data tab. In the Competing Risk Analysis section, you can easily switch the model to the cost-specific hazard function to estimate that instead. This ability to easily see how the results compare when you make different adjustments to your model is one of the useful features of the task. Let's click the running person icon to submit the code. If you scroll down in the results, you see that the results from this model are very similar to results from the Find and Gray model, although that is not always the case. Again, the disease group is a strong predictor of the occurrence of relapse. Additionally, if you scroll down to the graph, you see that the estimated CIFs look similar as before. A nice feature of the cost-specific hazard approach is that it estimates the model multiple times using the different competing risk as the event of interest. This is not possible or valid in the Find and Gray framework. If you scroll up to the results of the model where death was the event of interest, you see that the group variable is no longer significant, so the disease group was important for relapse but not for death. This sort of information would have been missed if a traditional survival analysis would have been conducted instead. From here, you could continue to modify the task to easily see how the results compare with different settings, or you could use it to create output datasets. You could also edit the generated code or export the results to various formats such as PDF or HTML. As you can see, the task in SAS Studio enable you to quickly and easily develop code for a competing risk survival analysis. For more information, please visit the SAS Stat product page and the SAS Studio task reference guide. Thanks for watching.